kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Florida State has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Makes it out to about the 39. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Run right side. Makes it to the 47.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2.
He makes it out to midfield. The quarterback kept it for himself and got the first down.
I'll tell you what, you got to be a tough quarterback to run this kind of offense. You take so many more hits, it can really get banged around, even on a good day.
He's at the 40. Makes it to the 31. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
And we'll take a break while the injured player is attended to. First and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. He's on the run. And they make the stop around the 23-yard line. Gains his way to the 13-yard line. To about the 5. And they'll get him in the backfield.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Third and 5. Ball on the 7. Tigers quarterback went down with that injury earlier. He's the general of this offense, and they're really going to have to find a way to try to win this game without him. Auburn is looking to go up by 3. He gets it up, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He zips it out to the left, and it's intercepted. Nice interception and an even nicer vertical.
Oh, yeah, this guy's an athlete. There's no throwing it over this guy's head. He'll go up and get it.
Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44. Auburn holds a field goal lead. He's at the 30. makes it to the 21. What a play.
Just a simple option play here. The quarterback gives it up, and they get good yardage. Great play.
He's taken down at the 19. The 10. And down he goes around the 2-yard line. Dives for extra yardage. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
We've got second and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. And he's tackled just outside the goal line.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
Touchdown, Tigers. And he hits the PAT. So that's a 6-play, 49-yard drive. And they get it in for 7.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for a defense.
They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Tackle made at the 47-yard line. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble. Now he's going to run, and watch out. Slides down.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
Really good play here and run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Offense lines up in a 5-wide set. The defense anticipating pass here. He scrambled, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Ball is loose, fumble. Scoops up the loose ball, and he's taken down right around the 22-yard line. He's tackled at about the 9-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. That brings him second and goal. Down at the 2. There are three quarters remaining. Auburn's got a 10-point lead. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
Kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. He makes the PAT. Florida State gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Auburn has a 3-point lead. Fires quickly to the tight end. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line.
You feel bad to criticize anybody for being aggressive, but if he wouldn't have bit on the play action, I don't know if they would have been able to pick up the first down.
Gains his way to the 49-yard line. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. Out to around the 38.
Woo, defense, let's go. That brings up second and one.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Green, 36, 36.
Caught out of the open, and he tackles him hard at the 32. Gain of 6 on the pass, and that's good for a first down.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down to keep the offense on the field.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. He's got it with room to run, and he hits him hard at the 23.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Auburn is up a field goal. Look at a scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
This is the 8th play of the drive. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's pushed out of bounds at the 12. He's got it out to his tight end. Big play, and it's first and goal. They give to the tailback. Tackle around the 1 yard line.
That brings him second and goal.
point.
It was an 11-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. This time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he's taken down at the 16.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Hands it off. He gets to about the 27-yard line. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 27. Scrambling around, and they get the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 33.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That makes it third and three.
Check tight right. Pull it out there. Check it out. It's out there.
Three down.
Tackled after decent pickup.
That's a gain of 5 on the play.
That makes it. It's first and 10. Ball on the 38. He's scrambling. He's wrapped up for the sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
He's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked.
Brad, not only did they give up the sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page. And they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. Throw incomplete, one of his receivers.
It's always tough trying to put the ball out of the defender's reach, but where your guy can still come down with it in bounds. It takes a lot more precision than it looks.
So the officials taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
So the call on the field will be reversed. They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. He really got a hold of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
And they got him, and they get a nice defensive play.
Now here's a play you don't see very often. That time they brought pressure from the corner position, and the line couldn't pick him up, and he was able to wrap the quarterback up for a sack. That's a good defensive call.
It's second and 12. Ball on their own 18.
Thank you.
fires that quickly, incomplete.
Wow, Brad, you talk about having a strong arm. Next time, though, he might want to work on the accuracy.
From their own 18-yard line, third down. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. So they run the ball on third and long, and it's stuck.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. The senior corner, and he is drilled at the 7-yard line. We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. Auburn's got a 10-point lead.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This first half could have long-lasting implications, not only for this season, but for the career of this coach who's really getting some attention in some big circles. He's going to be a very hot commodity.
Well, it's one thing to do it against the little boys. It's another thing when you come and you pull the stunners. I mean, when you beat teams that you're not supposed to beat, that's when coaches make their money. I mean, think about it. It's easy to beat teams that are as talented as you or less talented. But when you go against a team that across the board, the talent discrepancy is in big favor on the other side, and you can get a big W like this, 100%, it's a highlight on the resume. It's something that coaches and programs are going to be looking for big-time coaches down the road. They'll be looking for you.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, we always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Now he tries to buy some time. That makes 4 sacks today.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. He's on the run. Decides to slide, and he just slid down to avoid the contact there.
You know, Brad, sometimes a quarterback's got to get down low to protect himself. But in this case, try to show some guts. Break a tackle and get downfield. Look for the first down.
Quick throw. And they'll bring him down behind the line. Not much there on the screen play.
It's a nice play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. Heading for the corner. Oh, he got nailed on that one.
When he made the decision to return the ball, I'm sure he thought there was going to be some room to run. But boy, did it vanish in a hurry. Still, he got something out of it.
They're set to go for another round. Strike to his receiver, no good.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
From their own 43-yard line,
Second down. And down he goes at the 45. Makes it out to about the 29. Short of the line of scrimmage.
It's a great play by the defense, but it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 30-yard line. And he's level at the 20-yard line. Forward to about the 20. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And they make the stop at about the 17-yard line. Play of this drive. He's on the run. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Get him in the backfield. Just throws this one away. It's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks away, and the field goal is good. Auburn kicked this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Their last drive broke down, and they punted. What do they have in store this time out?
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
The run, right side. Gains his way to the 40-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Out, and he's going to get sacked.
That makes it second and 14.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Good. I got it.
slings it. He has some room. Tackle made
around the 40-yard line.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Quick strike to the receiver. That's a great tackle at the 36. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. Gain of two.
Wasn't a huge gain here, but at least you know as a quarterback that when you throw to this senior, you're putting the ball into some sure hands.
From the 34-yard line, third down. They lose four there.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage. That makes it worth an inning.
Roger, Roger! My five! My five! You gonna get this, boy? You think you gonna get this?
Throws complete, but he's gonna come up short.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Taken down around the 47-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, Auburn in front, 20-7. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Taken down at about the 45.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he's tackled at the 46-yard line. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Gives it to the back. Runs it left for a decent gain. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Down.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up and man, work that slant route until they stop it.
Quick pass. He's tackled around the 45-yard line.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Gets to about the 44-yard line. Tackle at the 32-yard line. Scrambling. Ball is loose. Fumble. And they fall on the loose ball. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Just under three to go in regulation. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. He rifles it. And it's incomplete.
Number 15 intended to see the play. That'll make it fourth and 10.
Watch the screen. Like five.
Got his receiver, but it's knocked out. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run up the middle. Florida State's going to take their first time out of the half. We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 37. Here's the give. He's at midfield. Brought down around the 38-yard line.
When you combine his speed as a runner with the strength of the offensive line, you have the potential for some long runs.
And they get nice yardage on that run. The Seminoles using their third and last timeout. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Makes it out to about the 17-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And that's a first down.
First down, and now they have an opportunity to run some more time off the clock.
And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 20-7, Tigers. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.